E ngā rangatira o te ao Māori, tēnā koutou katoa. He uru tapu nui anō o te wao nui a tāne, kua turakina ki raro. Ko weremu weremu, kai urungi waka, noroto mai o te tai tokerau, kua karangahia e ōna mātua tūpuna ki hoki, ki te kāinga o ngā matahī apo hokinga kore ki muri. Nō reira e kara, haere e hoki, whāia te ara moana i whārautia mai ai e rātou mā ki Hawaii ki whakamutunga. Hoki rawa mai ki a tātou ngā mahuetanga o rātou mā tihei Māori ora. No te wiki nei i puta mai ai i te kāwanatanga, tā rātou tahua pūtea mō tēnei tau. Neke atu i te 200 miliona tāra i tītarihia mai ki ngā kaupapa Māori, hei tautoko i ngā whānau, tamariki me te iwi Māori katoa i ngā āenga o te mate korona. Engari, ko ngā tino kaiwhiwhi, ko te kohanga reo me whānau ora. I kōreroa Marae, ki te minita whānau ora ki a Pēni Hēnare, me te minita o te arawhiti me Kelvin Davis i kōtata ake nei.
Tuatahi, me whakatau i te wāhi ki o tātou matea, ko te rangatira hoi waka o te tai tokerau, weremu weremu tērā. Pēni, hea o kōrero mōna mō weremu weremu?
E te tuhunga whakararata nei i ngā tai tamariki, tai tokerau o te motu whānui. Tako o tō mai rā koe ki runga i tō waka o ngātu ki matawhaurua. E taku waka whiti tua, hoi atu rā ki tai horo nukurangi i whakapēpehatia e o tātou mātua. E o tātou tūpuna. Ka tahi rā te kaumātua, ka tahi rā te tohunga i whakararata mai, ki poipoia mai nei i a mātou ko ngā tai tamariki, kā tie te pāpāe wiremu, haere, haere, haere atu rā.
Tēnā koe, Pēni, atāhua, tēnā poroporo aki e mihi ana ki a koe. O tira, ki a kōrua tahi, ki a hoki mai ki a tātou te hunga ora. Me kōrero tātou mo te tahua pūtea, the budget this week. Kelvin, $200 million to kohanga reo ko roa rātou e tatari ana kia whāngai hia rātou ki te pūtea. They've been waiting a little while to get a big boost in funding, $200 million. As I said, they've been waiting a little while for that, so why now?
Oh, because they deserve it and it's long overdue. Under the previous government, really, the relationship between the government and the Kohangareo National Trust, it just stalled and as a result, they struggled really, and one of the first things that we did when I became the Associate Minister of Education and responsible for Māori education is we sat around my table and I said to them, look, you know, I grew up monolingual. I struggled as a Māori to learn the language, and it's every Māori child's right to be able to speak Māori, and I don't want any other Māori child to struggle like I did. So I think probably what's more important than the sum of $200 million is the relationship that we've started to rebuild with the Kohangareo National Trust, with the government, and we're working together in what I think is a true tiriti-based partnership to achieve the aspirations of the Kohangareo. They got $32 million last year, $200 this year. You know, we're on that journey to support, to make sure that our reo flourishes and thrives for future generations.
Kei te waiata rātou, kei te huro rātou, i tēnei pūtea nui ki a rātou. And I think, yeah, that what the point you made about growing up monolingual, I can definitely identify with that and the struggle to learn our reo. And it's really important that we do give our children the birthright of having te reo Māori as first language. So,
It is a right. It is a right, you know, to be able to speak our own language.
Tēnā koe, Pēni. Tahi rau, toru te kaumāono miliona tāra ki a whānau ora e hoa. Engari, ka rere tērā pūtea ki here on a practical level. Where does all that money go? $136 million for whānau ora.
Ai, tuatahi māku ka mihi atu ki ngā kaikumihana me ngā ratonga hāpuri nei. The commissioning agencies and the whānau ora provider network across Aotearoa did a fantastic job during COVID-19. So that commitment about where the money goes and what it goes towards is something that we'll craft out with those people who deliver it. And I'm committed to that and looking forward to making sure that in a post-COVID world, our whānau get the services that they need in the best way that they can.
Now, it's not going to Te Puni Kōkiri, is it? Is it going straight to the whānau ora providers?
I can tell you that of the announcement yesterday, only 1% is going to Te Puni Kōkiri, and that is primarily just administrative. The government agencies have an administrative function here. 1% of the money announced yesterday for whānau water will go towards that. The rest of it, ehoa, is all about whānau water in a post-COVID world.
Tēnā koe. Kelvin, kia hoki tāua ki te kororo mō te reo, because apart from the 200 million te kohanga reo, there's another 200 million going to te reo Māori me te whakarau oratanga o te reo Māori. What does that look like? Where does that spread of pūtea go in terms of te reo Māori revitalisation?
Well, we kicked off Te Ahu o Te Reo, which is a kaupapa that is basically supporting teachers in predominantly mainstream settings to integrate Te Reo Māori throughout the curriculum, so that every child in New Zealand has exposure to Te Reo Māori. One of the things that I'm really most proud of is that over the years we've focused on investing in schools and tamariki as we should, and in principals and teachers. The component that was missing, in my opinion, was investment also in the whānau, because the whānau always is going to be there. And so 50 million of those dollars are going into supporting whānau so that they can engage and work with the education system and help them to support their tamariki. So there's some more pūtea going towards working for over 4 years, 300 whānau who have children in immersion education, them actually participating in te reo Māori so that they can engage with their tamariki and their tamariki's learning. So all up, $400 million for Māori education. And I'm just so wrapped with that, because to be honest, that's what I got into Parliament for, is to make improvements to Māori education. And yesterday it happened.
Yes, late this week, the government heard our cries and backed down from its original level 2 rule, restricting attendees at a tangi to no more than 10. The new rules, increasing that number to 50, at least give whānau the chance to mourn in the way we always have. But for many, the pandemic and lockdown has stopped us from practising these ancient rites of pangihana. Whatitiri te wake's whānau are among them.
Kua uhia e mātou ko taku whānau te kākahu taratara i te matenga o tōku karanga tuakana a Anthony Wee John e ono wiki ki muri.
We thought maybe level three first of all, and then we got to level three, and then disappointment again.
We're just lucky that we got a good whānau that are understanding and patient, and you know.
He tawhiti a manu rewa i tā maki makaurau ki tō mātou tūranga waiwai i Panguru, Hokianga. Me te aha kua roa nei te taonga o mate, e tirahā nei te mātau o te whare tūpāpaku. E noho tā wewe tonu ana tōna wairua i wainga i te ao kikokiko me te ao wairua.
We don't just have it for the sake of having it. There's actually like really good reasons why we do the things that we do. Closure, healing, so that we can slowly but and surely try and like move forward.
Ā, ko te mamaitanga nui mō Aua Wiki e ono I whakamoia ngā tikanga.
Being in a foreign place, where he's laid at now, was a bit upsetting. You know, we haven't had the chance to put him to rest yet and get him to rest in peace, as they say. But just, you know, faith, you know, because we've been having a lot of prayers, asking, you know, praying that we can put the bro to rest. And it's just faith in God as well that has kept us going, kept us strong.
I think we've been undermined a little bit. Our mana motuhake, our rangatiratanga, has been challenged deeply and greatly during this time. We're not stupid people. None of us want to go out there and get this coronavirus and die.
Ara noa ngā whakapaparanga o tēnei tū whai āhuatanga I mate whawhati tata a Anthony mai I te mate manawa. Hei tāpiritanga atu ki tēnā, te noho rāhui ā motu, ā kaore I āhei kia whakahoki I te tūpāpaku ki te wā kāinga.
So they had to decline on their part. See, we only had the restrictions to 10 on the grieving side and the taking them, but what about the getting our minister or whoever we nominate to, and our kaumātua to lead the services up there? You know, we're asking that of them, for them to break their bubbles in order to lay ants to rest, because their side wasn't clarified. But out of respect for them, we decided, yes, the best thing is to hold back.
Ko ia nei tō mātou u kaipō i Panguru, no nanahi nei hoki atu te taonga o mate ki te rua kōiwi o ō mātou tūpuna.
It's the most beautiful place in the world. Here a lot of mates going overseas and that. But on our doorstep, you know, we overlook the sea, we overlook the harbour, everything's at our doorstep.
Engari kātahi te haerenga mōrikarika ko tēnei.
Tā te tikanga Māori, we've had to put it on hold, we've had to adjust. Ordinarily, ko te mahi a te tūpoupou, ki te kirimate is me noho tahi, me noho piri ki te taha o te tūpapuku. Tae no rawa ki te tanumetanga ki te whenua. But that, again, hasn't been the case. We've had to adapt. I mean, I've even taken my phone into my refrigerator to show the family and say, kei kone ia te koto ana, taking photos. We dress the body, take photos. And some families say, oh, kaore, we don't want you to give us that. You know, and beautiful, kei te pai. Some say, yes, please send us a photo. Ordinarily, that goes against what I'm about.
Ko Francis tērā e whakakanohi ana i tēnei take i te ao pāpāho mo te roanga ake o tēnei wiki. Ko ia hoki te kaitiaki o Anthony me te maha noa atu i ngā wiki kua taha.
I'm aware that a lot of people probably can't sleep or are not settled in their homes, knowing that their loved ones are here with Francis and the tipine funerals. You know, so we've got to think about what are we going to do. I feel like our wairua, our tūpapaku, are okay, ko pai rātou, because for all of them, karakia has been had. Lots of prayers. But I think we have to concentrate on te hunga ora, their living respective families, and taking care of them.
E marama ana tōku whānau ki ngā whakatūpatotanga o te noho rāhui, haunga anō kaore mātou e hiahiana kia horapa anō te mate urutā, ko te rarupea, ko te whakakorenga o ngā tikanga, me te pōhehe, kaore mātou e mōhio ana ki te whakahaere ia mātou anō. Nō reira, kei taku tuakana karanga maha. Okioki koe i te atarau o Taiwa Maunga o Panguru Papata, ki te rua whakautu o ngā mātua tūpuna, e moe, e moe, whakangaro atura.
Nā, ko te tangihana te hui tapu nui, mana nui o te katoa i te ao Māori. Kei roto i te tangihana, ngā tikanga tuku iho katoa e pakoto ana. Tai atu ki te whakapono, ki te ao wairua, ki o tātou atua Māori motuhake tonu. Hei tā etahi e hara i te hui, engari he pā hekohekotanga, he ohutanga o te ao wairua me te ao kikokiko, te ao tangata me te ao atua. Ka tai mai te Pākehā ki Aotearoa, ka whakawhāitihia mai o nā māharahara hauora mo te tangihana ki roto i etahi ture, hei tāmi i ngā tikanga tū pāpaku a te Māori. Kia hatia, ka arotau tātou, ka hangaia he tikanga hou, engari ko te uho o te tuku i te tangata ki Hawaiki, kei te hāpaitia tonutia e tātou. I kōrero a Marae, ki te minita whānau ora kia pēni hēnare me te minita o te arawhiti me Kelvin Davis i kōtata kenei.
Penny, it's been a huge week for Māori politics e hoa, with te iwi Māori questioning the government's distrust in Māori delivering our tikanga safety like tangihana, not to mention the Public Health Response Act raising questions amongst Māori as well. What do you have to say to te iwi Māori e riri nei ki a koutou, e whakapono mimiti haere nei ki a koutou i roto i enei tu āhuatanga o te tuku? Mā te Māori anō, te Māori a whakahaere. There's a little bit of distrust amongst iwi now.
I kōrero tahi māua ko Kelvin me waku hoamahi e hoa. E hara tēnei i te haukoti, i te mana o tō tāua iwi. We've always been quite clear that and worked through the COVID-19 pandemic with our whānau. Kelvin, myself and my colleagues have regularly caught up with iwi. We've engaged with them. And, you know, when it comes to tangihanga, firstly, you know, my heart goes out to all of the whānau who have endured during this time. The reason for the decisions made around tangihanga is primarily a public health message. I've said it on a number of occasions. My tupuna Tauhenare, when he was the MP in the pandemic in 1918, he buried our great-grandmother who passed away from the influenza. When she passed away in Tāmaki, she was told, the whānau were told, do not open the casket when we get back home. Sadly, our whānau opened the casket and it decimated my people of Ngāti Hine. So the decisions that were made with regard to tangihanga were on sound health advice. However, having said that, e te tuakana, kua rangona e mātou ki ngā anipā te iwi Māori. We've heard how mamae it has been for our people, and we've made those changes. My challenge to our whānau, and I know our marae do a fantastic job at looking after our tikanga and can handle hui like this. The challenge is for our whānau who don't take their tūpāpaku back to the marae, who keep their tūpāpaku at home. We need to continue to be vigilant to make sure that COVID-19 doesn't get a hold of our people into the future. So there have been some hard decisions, e hoa, but I hope that the whānau will realise that this has been with the public health interest at heart.
Now, you see, Penny, when you deliver that message and you tell me why it's done, kei te māra māhau. I understand it, I get it. So how come you didn't front it? Why weren't you there announcing that this is going to be the procedures around tangihana rather than let the Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern deliver it? I think people, te iwi especially, might have been more clear about it, more receptive of it, if it had come from one of our Māori politicians such as yourself.
Yeah, and that is a valid point there, te tuakana. One of the challenges in Alert Level 4 and 3 was that Parliament only had restricted numbers for those of us who had to travel to Parliament. You know, I was in Tāmaki for this time, and my colleagues and I, despite the travel differences and the ture here in Parliament, continued to work together with the Prime Minister. And I can tell you and reassure the whānau that the Prime Minister took this to heart. This was something that has been playing on all of our minds. And while I appreciate that I wasn't there to front it, I hope that the whānau now, with the announcement and with the continued support of myself, Calvin, and our Māori colleagues, can find heart in what we're trying to do, and I welcome feedback on that, Ete Tua.
Ah, ka reo ku maharara ki tō tātou premier, he, wahine ngākau nui tērā, ki te ana e rongo ana i te aroha nui i roto i tērā wahine māraikura. Pātai whakamutunga ki a kōrua, ki a kōrua tahi tēnei pātai. We've been speaking about some of the challenges that COVID-19 has brought to our world and to Aotearoa whānui tonu. But as a Māori politician during these times, Calvin, what's been the greatest challenges and responsibilities as a Māori politician?
Well, keeping our people safe is probably the biggest challenge. You know, none of the decisions that we've made lightly. You know, now people are feeling the effects of, you know, job losses and that. But we said, look, our health response was our best economic response. Because if we hadn't have had that strong health response, well, then we would have had decimation of our people. Getting people to understand the reasons why we've done things is often difficult. They think we've been, you know, overplaying our authority. They think that we're almost doing it just to be a humbug to people. Well, the reality is that we were doing it in the best interest. We had to make decisions in hours and days. You know, we didn't have weeks or months to make decisions, and just making sure that we made the right decisions, even if people didn't agree with them, we had to make those decisions to keep our people safe.
Tēnā koe. He kororo tāpiri wāu, Penny. Mō ngā uuatanga o te noho hei kai tōranga pū Māori roto i ngā whiu o te mate korona.
E hoa, kua kōrero mai a tōku tuakana Calvin mō taua āhuatanga. Hoi no tāku hei mihi atu ki te iwi Māori. Ki roto i tēnei tū āhuatanga, kua pakari nei te ao Māori, aha kua te aha. And it's really been quite a privilege to see the way our whānau have reacted to COVID-19. And I look forward collectively to working with them and to making sure that our whānau continue to feel supported in a post-COVID world. Ngā mihi e te tuakana.
E mihi atu ana ki a kōrua tahi Calvin Davis, Penny Henare, me pēheara, e kore ea i te kupu. Engari, mihi ana ki a koutou o te kāwanatanga i tā koutou ārahi i te motu i roto i ngā uuatanga o te mate korona nei. Tēnei ka mihi, tēnei ka oha. tēnā rā wā atu kōrua. Kia ora tātara.
Ai, kia ora, Scotty.
Ka pai, Chief, tō whetero.
As we ease into level two and that bit closer to the way things were, some of the nastier bits of the old normal are very much hoving back into view, like racism. Before and during the pandemic, a kuia in one of Aotearoa's most expensive suburbs has been on the receiving end of racism. Paul Takamaipi with the story.
Mēnā ka whakaro tātou ki a rimutahi I tāma kēka toko ake ngā kupu pēnei I te huatau, te utu nui me ngā ia o te wā. Engari kāre tātou I te whakaro ki tēnei.
To the female householder, I have been a resident at Vermont Street, Ponsonby for 23 years. Since the time that you have occupied the residence at Vermont Street, you have caused myself and my neighbours a lot of upset, to say the least.
Te karere kaikiri I tau ki te pauaka reta a Rose Epiha I mua tata tonu I te rāhui whakamohoao.
Yeah, I've lived here for over 7 years, and during that time I've had threats, death threats from the white power to burn my house down with me in it. I've been called nigger monkey several times. So the letter's quite tame compared to those experiences I've had.
The language and level of vulgar display of disgusting behaviour that you produce is absolutely vile. What do you think they are referring to there?
My being Māori, my speaking Māori, my being very proud to be Māori, openly proud to be Māori. That's who I am.
Poho kere ru ana, reo kākā ana. Kua whakamā kore a Rose ki te hāpai te tino rangatiratanga me ngā tikanga Māori ki waho I tō na whare kaunihera. He kai rāranga tēnei kuia no te tai tokerau I tipu ake kei raro I ngā parirau o ngōna kuia.
He mahi au ngā taonga o ngā mātua tūpuna, ngā taonga tuku iho. He mahi tino hohuni tēnā. I te wā I rāranga nāu kei te ao ngā tūpunau. Oku whaia tūpuna, he mahi wairua, he mahi āroha, he mea tino nui ki au. And I ako au etahi atu I nei mea, he honore tēnei ki au.
Eke rawa ana ki te puku o te rāhui, ka rere tonu ngā kai kiritanga ko te kupu pūreta in, ko ngā whakahau ka wehe ia, kaore he mutunga.
I don't want my mokopuna to grow up and be whakamā because of the colour of their skin. So I feel I have a responsibility to continue what I was taught by my kuia. And that is to have love for everyone.
I ngā tau rima tekau, ono tekau me ngā whitu tekau hoki, kaore te tai o te kiri I te aha I rimutahi, nā te mea he kiri parauri te nuinga, he Māori, he iwi mautere hoki. Ua ua ana te whakapono I nāianei, engari I taua wā he māma te utu mō enei whare.
The ethnic volcano of Ponsonby has rumbled quietly for the past few years with protestations of racial prejudice. Ponsonby is the heart of Auckland's only real claim to fame, but it's the biggest Polynesian city in the world.
I nāianei he ua ua te hoko whare I konei ki raro I te 2 miriona tāra, ua ua hoki te kite kanohi parauri, I ēnei rā hoki he hāpori Pākehā, tēnei e hāpai ana I te rī peratanga, te Māuitanga me te tau āwhitanga, nō reira e pauri ana ētahi he kai kiritanga kei wāinga I a rātau.
Myself and my neighbours have worked hard our whole lives. We pay top rate. You have done nothing.
Everybody, all ages, all nationalities, from the rainbow community, everybody is welcome here in my house. And if I had the opportunity to say to the letter writer, come and talk to me. I'm a really nice person. You might actually get to like me if you bother to come and talk to me.
Kua tahuri hoki ngā hoa ki te tautoko I a Rose.
The person carries a bit of shame. They're too ashamed to put their name to those you know, the sentiments that they've expressed. They want to inflict shame on Rose, but they can't do that. Like, beautiful woman, brilliant artist, lots of mana, you know, like that shame belongs to the person who wrote that letter, because they, you know, they don't want their family, their friends, their employer, they don't want people to know that, you know, that they're a bully. So yeah, you know, no courage.
We need to keep saying that it's not acceptable. We don't all think that that's right to do this to others, you know? It's just no way to be in a community. I grew up in a community where you knew every other neighbour, or you could run into every other house, you know, and you knew you were safe. And I know that times have changed where you can't do that anymore. I get that. But you still have to have that sense of community.
Moros, he mamai, mamai rawatu. Engari, hei tāna ka eke panuku te aroha ki te mau ahara me te kai kiritanga I ngā wā katoa.
I think it's a normal response to be angry and hōhā, but I don't want those sorts of incidences to change the person that I am. So I was brought up by kuia, and I ako au ko te mea nui ko te aroha ki te iwi whānui. So I have lived experience of what aroha can do for people, for your whānau, for your mokopuna.
Tourette's syndrome is one of those conditions that medical science just doesn't fully understand yet. The uncontrollable tics, the blinking, throat clearing, and sometimes unpredictable outbursts of swearing and racial slurs. If that's hard to be exposed to, it's even harder to live with. Pere Wihongi has that story.
Disgusting woman.
Whakapai.
Ahuki mune punu tūunu fū.
Pō taro taro.
That's mean as.
Tunu keke.
That's that whole goddamn thing.
Everyday activities that prove a struggle. But for Leighton Clark, it's also...
I'm so sorry, Libby.
Cracking viral charts.
This is why I ask people to do my eggs for me.
The question!
Yeah!
Whoa! I'm Jasmine!
To all the whānau, you're gonna get a shock, but this is the reality I live.
Oosh!
Well, kia ora whānau, my name's Uncle Tix. I kind of blew up on TikTok just a little bit. Yeah, low-key, just kind of riding their waka on that wave, eh?
Mama, how are you, Moji?
Ko te waka ko tui papori, eke nei I ngā ngaru ipurangi. Viral content created by himself and his flatmates, starting right here in his driveway.
This driveway, me and Jack are always running up and down this bloody driveway doing dumb shit. I'm gonna get you!
Well, the first video he did, me and Alex were working outside, and he was like, oh, he ran in from inside, and he was like, okay, I've got an idea for a video, I just want to film you guys if that's all right. I'm like, mate, we just finished our workout.
Kia ora whānau. Today I'm doing a television interview.
Now Uncle is putting the tick in TikTok.
It's a tick. It's pretty much like a movement or something I'm doing at the time that I can't help.
Showing in true form tics, which is the side effect of a condition commonly known as Tourette's or Tourette syndrome.
So a tick is pretty much a involuntary movement that I can't help. So me throwing myself around like that, which is my brain telling my body to do that for some stupid bloody reason.
E ono oroto I te kotahi mano tāngata, ka whānau mai me te mate kahuki. Although only a small number of these people will ever be diagnosed, the majority will have tics that are so mild that they may not even be aware that they have the disorder.
And today, I'm going to cut my hair because I've got an ugly ass head. Do you know what Tourette's is? I'm like, not really, I just kind of swear and, you know, do funny movements all day and, oh, but yeah, it's quite a hard case, really. But I know this for a fact. Oh, penis. If I hold something in too long, sorry, team. If I hold something in too long, it just builds up and builds up and builds up to the point where I just pretty much pop.
Even things like getting a haircut, forced only to stick with a barber who knows the effects of his condition, this has been the norm since being first diagnosed at age 9.
Ring, 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 ring.
it was horrible. And I was stuck onto these really strong pills that would make me into a second person. It wasn't nice at all. Growing up, it was horrible. Absolutely horrible, you know, nothing worked for me. Even though I passed all my grades, I even did everything I needed to do, it was horrible.
Coprolalia, the involuntary utterance of profanities, obscenities, and derogatory remarks. It's the extreme example of vocal tics, which only 10% of Tourette's cases exhibit.
When I go to the pa, out the Marae, a lot of the kaumata obviously know me and, you know, I'm always out there screaming or doing something funny while they're having their meetings. The reason I took my retarded bum to TikTok was because I wanted people to understand it more. There's not enough information on Tourette's out there. And people judge and don't understand, so.
Now he slowly ticks the boxes to becoming the next social media star.
My big goal is to get the knowledge of Tourette's out there for all our whānau, whenua and our whānau all over the land. I want to get the knowledge of Tourette's out there so people understand it more so they don't judge me when I'm walking on the street.
Akaati ko ana kupu whakamutunga ki te hunga hauwā me te hunga rangatahi.
So the best bit of advice from Uncle Tix is be a bit more open-minded. I just want to help the younger generation understand that it's okay to be disabled. And be loud and be proud. I think that's the biggest Jack, you suck balls. I think that's the biggest thing for me to say.
Nō reire, kare mā, koe rā tā tātou hōtaka mō tēnei rātapu. E mihi ana ki ngā manuhiri o te rā, o tira ki ngā tāngata katoa, i whakai mai kia uiuitia e mātou. Kia rongo ai tātou, i ā rātou kōrero, i ō rātou whakaaro. E te iwi, noho ahuru tonu mai rā, kia ora tātou katoa.